Hello, welcome from sunny Malta. This is JP and the team for Radio International. And next to us now is a contestant to the Malta Eurovision Song Contest, who we met in 2014 for the Malta Eurovision Song Contest 2015, which is a bit confusing. But now Raquel Galdes is with us. Hi. How are you?
Okay, till now.
Yeah?
It's cold, but it's okay.
We're outside the venue, actually, where you're going to be competing on Friday, the 20 acts that are competing for the 14 places on Saturday. And then out of this, the winner goes to Stockholm. So how was the rehearsal for you for the first time here in this building?
It's different. The fact that it's a theater and not something, so it's different, something new. Mm-hmm. I never had a performance yet, so it's my first time. But now it's okay, I mean. I just got out from my first rehearsal, so... Mm.
Well, it's a bit of a historic building as well. It's the former infirmary of the Knights. Debbie Sherry won in here, and also Glenn Vella won in here, won to Eurovision. So it's quite a historic building itself. You've been before in Marsa, now you're here. So what's your favorite venue so far?
I've been to Ali in Marsa and here. It's my third time. Mm-hmm. But my favorite one was Marsa, of course. It was the biggest venue. Even the stage was amazing. So
it was the Junior Eurovision stage used the week before. Let's talk about the song "Flashing Lights" that's in the running this year. Your song number 9 with this. Tell us about what's the message in the song and the creation of it.
The message is about hope about anything. It could be people can relate to it for themselves. For example, for me, it can relate to a dream mm-hmm. to become something, a dream, or maybe hope, maybe a person has gone out from a wrong relationship and hope to be feeling okay. So I have the same team as 2 years ago, Matt Moshe Merchi and Elton Zarb.
It's a winning team, actually.
Yes.
They won the 2 Junior Eurovision Song Contest entries.
Yes.
And they have many, many songs in the running as well.
Yes.
Is that for you as an artist, not, how can I say, they're not only focusing on you, but also they have others. So what type of feeling is that for you?
But they really focus like on individuals. I mean, they're the only 2 composers and daughters. I know that before we come to rehearse here, they actually rent another theater so that we can rehearse with them there. And then we just come here like we're ready on stage and not something new.
Excellent.
So even today, they just talked to me before. The attention is individual.
Is there. That's fantastic. That's good. How will you perform the song? Can you describe the staging of it a little bit?
This year, I'm not alone for the first year. I will be having 2 dancers and actually a band, the drummer, bassist and guitarist.
Mm-hmm.
So we're full.
Excellent. And how do you do it? You will be standing still, or and the dress, of course. We want to know about from you as well. What will you be wearing?
I will be standing. I will be starting a bit from the behind and then walk through to the mic stand. And then the dancers will just be lower than me, but I will basically standing all the time on the mic stand.
Okay.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
But I have a choreography, but mostly with my hands and my head. And the dress, the colors on the stage are black and silver,
mm-hmm.
because
that's
it's flashing lights.
Flashing lights.
My dress will be black. I have chains, mm-hmm. and basically that's it. Even the LEDs in the background, the graphics mm-hmm. are silver.
Let's go away from Malta Eurovision Song Contest. Eurovision itself. You watched last year's event in Vienna. What was your favorite?
The one that won, actually. But I had another favorite. I can't remember what Monster, a Monster Like Me.
Oh, the Norwegian entry.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I love that one.
Nice, very nice. What is your specialty in singing? You're more like a lady that likes to sing ballads, or you would also try to do something upbeat, like Heroes, for instance, was upbeat?
Not that upbeat, but not that ballad. maybe something soft rock. But more with an upbeat,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
but not something like Sweden, the song that won, let's say Heroes. So.
Heroes, yeah. Excellent. Okay, we wish you all the best of luck for the semi-final on Friday and on Saturday, hopefully then as well, that it goes well. Thanks for talking to us, and all the best of luck.
Thank you.